Welcome. Today we will discuss triangles. In this, we go through exercise 7.2. The first question: ABC is an isosceles triangle. In this triangle, the side AB is equal to AC, and the rays OB and OC are the angle bisectors of angle B and angle C. We have to show that OB is equal to OC, and AO bisects angle A. To prove this, first of all we have to recall in the isosceles triangle two sides are equal, then their opposite angles are equal. We have to draw that figure first. Here the side AB and AC are equal, so that their opposite angles are angle C and angle B are equal. I am writing AB is equal to AC, so the opposite angle of AB side is angle C. I will denote this angle C as angle ACB. That is equal to the angle opposite to side AC is angle ABC. So I am supposing that these two angles are x degrees. And we have known that OB is the angle bisector of angle B. So we can write that angle ABO is equal to angle OBC. These two angles are equal. Then it will become x by 2. And OC is the angle bisector of angle C. Then we can write that angle ACO, this angle is equal to this angle. That is also x by 2. Now we got that this is x by 2 and this is also x by 2. It is x by 2, it is also x by 2. Let us take the triangle OBC, the smaller triangle we will take. In triangle OBC, we have got that angle OBC is equal to angle OCB. In a triangle, if two angles are equal, then their opposite sides are equal. So the opposite side of this angle OBC is equal to OC. And the side opposite to angle OCB is side OB. This we have to prove. Yes, we have proved this. And we have to prove one more, that is AO bisects angle A. So take the two triangles, triangle AOB and triangle AOC. We will write in triangle AOB, comma triangle AOC. In these two triangles, what are equal? So I can write angle ABO is equal to angle ACO. That is equal to x by 2. And now itself we got that OC is equal to OB. And side AB is equal to AC. This is from given. So by ASA property, triangle AOB is congruent to triangle AOC. If two triangles are congruent, then what will happen? The corresponding parts are equal. Here the corresponding parts are angle BAO, this angle is equal to angle OAC. We can write angle BAO is equal to angle OAC. From this we can say that AO is the angle bisector of angle A. Let us discuss inequalities of a triangle. So to form a triangle, we have two conditions. They are called as inequalities. The first condition is the sum of any two sides should be greater than the third side. And we have one more condition, that is the difference of any two sides is less than the third side. These two are the inequalities to form a triangle. Let us check this condition. The first one, sum of two sides is greater than third side. Suppose your sum of two sides is equal to third side, then what will happen? I will show. This is one side. And I am going to take one more side. This is another side. So I am writing the names as A, B, C. Here, the side AB is having the length of 5 cm. Suppose the side BC is having 4 cm. Suppose if we measure AC, if it is equal to 9 cm, then here no triangle forms, because the sum of two sides is equal to the third side AC. So no triangle forms. Here the area of the triangle is 0. A comma B comma C are called as collinear points. If the sum of these two sides is greater than the third side, then what will happen? We will check that. This is one side, this is another side. And we take one more side, this one. We will name them as ABC. If it is 5 centimeters, it is 4 centimeters, then the side AB will be how much? It is not 9 centimeters. We can say that. It should be less than 9 centimeters. Suppose we can take the side AB as 1 to 8 centimeters, not 9 centimeters. Because if it is 9, then what will happen? This AB side will be equal to the sum of two sides. Then this AC side will be come this side, and this BA will be coinciding with this sum of the two sides. So this side is not like that. AB will be 1 to 8 centimeters. But we have one more condition, that is the difference of any two sides is less than third side. Here we take the difference. The difference between these two sides is 1 centimeter. So definitely the side AB should be more than 1 centimeter. So it should be more than 1 in the sense, let us take 2 centimeters. So AB will be 2 to 8 centimeters. Or more than 1, AB will be more than 1 centimeter. And less than 9 centimeters. With these measures only, this triangle will be formed. These two are the inequalities. And we go through some examples. Observe these three triangles. The first one is triangle ABC. In this, one angle is 70 degrees, another angle is 60 degrees. Then, what will be the third angle? Definitely, it will be acute angle. Why? Because the sum of these two angles is 130 degrees. So we require only 50 degrees to get 180 degrees. So that this 50 degrees is called acute. This triangle ABC is called acute triangle. Observe this triangle. In this triangle, the three angles are different. So that their opposite sides are also different. Angle A is greater than angle B and it is greater than angle C. So the opposite side of the greater angle is side BC, that will be longest side. This is greater than angle B. The opposite side of angle B is AC. So AC, it is greater than the opposite side of angle C is AB side. From this we can conclude that in a triangle, the side opposite to greater angle is longest side and the least angle is shortest side. That you have to remember. Just observe this triangle. This is right triangle. In this, right angle is at E and one angle is 40. In the right triangle, the sum of the two angles other than right angle is right angle. So the sum of these two angles should be 90. It is 40, so it will be 50. Here also the three angles are different. That's why their opposite sides are also different. Among these three angles, the greater angle is angle A. So that its opposite side is DF side. So DF is the longest side. Actually, it is the right triangle. That's why the side opposite to right angle is called hypotenuse. And look at the next figure. This is obtuse triangle. In this triangle, one angle is more than 90 degrees. So if it is 100, then definitely the remaining two angles should be acute angle only, because we have to get 80 degrees. So the sum of two angles should be 80. That's why the two angles must and should acute. That's why this 100 is the greatest angle. So its opposite side is GI. So GI will be the longest side in this triangle. And we will go through one more question from exercise 7.4. Just observe this figure. These are the measurements for the triangle, 4 centimeters and 6 centimeters. We have to find out the third side. Already we have discussed this question. Just observe. AB is equal to 4 centimeters. AC is 6 centimeters. We have to find out the third side BC. Already we have known the inequality. The sum of two sides is greater than third side. That means AB plus AC should be greater than BC. So the sum of these two sides is 10. 4 plus 6 is greater than BC, 10 greater than BC, what does it mean? BC should be less than 10. So, the possible values for BC are 1, 2, 3, 4, dash, dash, 8 and 9. And we have one more inequality, that is the difference of two sides is less than third side. So, AC minus AB is less than third side BC. AC is 6 centimeters. 6 minus 4 less than BC. So, 2 less than BC. What does it mean? It means BC is greater than 2. From this we can write that the possible values for BC are, just observe, BC should be greater than 2. That means these two measurements would not be taken into consideration. So we have to write the remaining measurements 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Here, one question is asked, that is, how many types of triangles can be obtained? Here we get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 types of triangles we can get with these measurements. And we have one more question, that is 7th one. Try to construct a triangle with 5 centimeters, 8 centimeters and 1 centimeter. Is it possible to construct? This is the question. So, can anyone say these two, with these measurements, we can draw a triangle or not? No. Why? Because the sum of two sides should be greater than third side. So, by adding these two, we get 6. 6 is not greater than 8. That's why no triangle forms. So, the reason what we have to write, that is the sum of two sides is not greater than third side. That's why here we cannot construct a triangle. Suppose then if this measurement is changed, then we can construct. So, what will be this measurement? That will be more than 3, because the difference is 3 centimeters. That's why it should be more than 3. That means it should start from 4 and up to the sum of two sides is 13. That's why the third side measurement should be less than 13. So that will be 12. So 4 to 12, with these measurements we can draw a triangle. So for you, the homework is complete exercise 7.2, 7.3 and 7.4. Thank you.